Good news tonight. It is an original program, and it's not a rerun. You're not going to see the bowling show again.
We're all here.
You're not going to see lesbian dating game again. You're seeing a fresh program.
Brand new.
With Run-DMC.
Go Hollis! Go Hollis!
Hey, yo!
Yeah!
Hey, yo!
Jim, okay,
yo, you better not throw nothing over here, man.
Yo, yo, with that popcorn.
This is the fourth time we've tried to see this movie.
Yeah, man, we need to get busy, man.
Just behave yourself and don't talk too loud.
Bobby God, Bobby God.
They're barbarians. Look at them down there. They're uncivilized, them people. I have just as much right to see this picture as they do.
Shut up, they'll hear you. They just kill you as eat popcorn.
You know something? They never have any money, but they always got money to go to the movies and bother people.
Just sit quiet. I want to see this
movie. Jay, they go to Godfather, man.
Yo, which one is this? What movie is this?
The Godfather, true.
Hey, yo, shut up.
Shut up. Yo, now I got you a punk.
Yeah, what? What?
He's gonna miss the movie, G.
Quiet, you'll get them mad.
Someone just lost their life for $7.50.
Look, I want to see this movie, and that guy was unlucky enough to get caught in the crossfire. Everybody just be quiet.
Yo, you thought I ended up for you, right?
Oh, my God, look.
We're in the middle of an undeclared war with these sheep.
Quiet down, quiet.
Oh, man, homo ladies, homo ladies.
Look, the lesbians.
Oh,
my God.
Yo, don't shut up. Yo, man, I put a bullet in that ass.
Oh, no.
Yo, man, Hollis, bum rush. Yeah, what?
What?
I shoot that ass for you.
Enough! Hey, stand up and finally confront you people with your boom boxes and your rap and your loud nonsense!
The blood clot women up in here.
Ha! Look it! I got a bulletproof vest on. I fooled you. I fooled you all.
Will Rogers, money for Will Rogers. Will Rogers.
You're worse than all of them.
You cool with us, baby. You cool with us. Get out of here.
Yo. Yo, let's get stupid deaf.
Yo, let's watch the movie, man. I hope it ain't too violent. I hope it ain't too violent. Yo, but I hope this is a cool movie.
Yo.
The young hums and swung on the swing. Climb on the side and ride the ding-a-ling. I didn't see a kid by the sea, so he saw middle monkey bars, monkey cars we adore. I'm gonna play through the gate, go to break drums, door. And my man from Japan, got he fixed for sure. Do me a favor when you roll with the crew. You gotta check out the avenue.
Ha! Yo, Joe. Hey, Buster, why don't you say something? Say, do that.
Run-DMC, I want to thank you boys for just men, sorry.
Yeah, what are you doing, Howard?
It's all right, We're happy to be here on the stupid dope show.
Stupid dope show.
Every night is stupid dope.
Here we go. Hey, Gary, I'm on camera.
We're on the air.
If you don't mind. What a jerk.
Do what television a... lately?
Such an unprofessional
show. Why don't you bring me an apple next?
Yeah. You got an apple there, boy?
Oh, man.
You know, your hats look beautiful tonight. First of all, I just want to say that to Run-DMC, the greatest rap group, they started rap. Didn't you guys start rap?
We wouldn't say we started it, but we kind of kicked the framalama for most of the people out there that wasn't up on the cahootness.
Yeah, but, well...
Shouldn't we be running subtitles?
Yeah, I mean...
Yeah, we need a translator.
You guys love all that jive talk, cahootness. Let me see your hair.
See, show him your hair.
Come on, let me see your hair.
No curls, no braids.
Take off the hat. Look at that. Yeah, oh, that's nice. And what do you got carved in the side of your head?
This is
the Soul Train line. People all over the world.
Let me ask you guys something.
I think he did that himself, though. He didn't actually go to a barber.
You paid a barber to cut those things on the side of your head? Really?
Oh, no. You got taken.
That's stupid fresh.
Yeah,
I mean it. But you guys had fun doing that sketch, huh?
Yeah, that was dope, man.
I thought you guys were good actors. I thought you did a pretty good job.
Yeah, we did movies before where we shot people in the face.
Yeah, I know. But how do you like my dying scene? Is that pretty cool when I was shaking on the floor?
You know, it was very reminiscent of one of my favorite films.
Which film?
We'd probably get an Oscar for that.
Night of the Living Dead.
Really?
The zombie
movie. Thank you. Hey, that's a good movie. I take that as a compliment. Yeah, you guys had a posse with you. Am I correct? A posse or crew? Is it a crew or posse?
Posse crew.
Because these guys had about 97 guys with them.
Yeah.
It was like a jungle back there. I felt like I was in Africa, for God's sake.
Well, I saw them traveling once, and they each got out of a different car.
You know,
the car was full of people.
It was literally like being in Africa. You guys had, and everybody's black with you guys. There's no white people, no white
You're lying. You're lying.
I didn't see a white man
with
you people.
We have a white guy.
What about Leo?
Where's Kip at?
Where is the whole posse?
We have a token white boy.
We have a posse, right?
We have a token white boy.
Right posse.
Come
here. Hey, go get Kip. Hey, he's a token white boy. Here we go. He's a white boy. With a Giants uniform on.
He's from the Raiders. He's from the Giants.
Nobody's from the Raiders.
What is
man?
The white guy? Nice jewelry. Now, is that a slave chain?
Actually,
is that what that is? Does that actually, represent
no,
all
listen,
of the...
I am so upset that I forgot my jewelry. I was working all night, but I wish I had on all my fat gold chains.
Is that to represent the man,
no.
the white
no,
man?
The gold no, chain
no it's just like this. You know, a lot of people are scared to wear their chains now, and I'm representing that I'm not scared.
And what does the white guy do?
He's from the mafia. You better stop talking to him.
No, what
like
did he do? What are you? Are you what do I? No, seriously. Now, are you? Is he considered?
Are you like a white guy who likes being black?
No.
Or?
No.
Are you talk black or you talk white?
Talk like normal, I guess.
You talk black.
Do you
talk black or white? What
do? You guys have a...
How do you talk? I'd like to know.
Beautiful.
She said she wanted to be taught some of our B-boy vernacular.
Run-DMC has a new album, Back From Hell.
Back from Hell.
Now, what does that mean, Back From Hell? Where were you, in hell?
No.
What do you mean, Back
what
From
it was,
Hell?
Well, to us, we've been away... We didn't make a record for 2 years, you
right.
know? So we call that, like, in hell, because we was away from the people.
Exactly.
We was away from being Run-DMC.
The thing is, Run-DMC is hotter than ever. You are Back From Hell. That's your album. We love it. We love it.
That's real rap.
Give us some points.
And may I say something in the street vernacular? Because when you say something is stupid, that means it's
an adjective.
It's an adjective. So you guys are the stupidest guys I know. All right?
Like I said, this is definitely a stupid, dope show.
This show is filled with stupid dope.
With a bunch of stupid dopes that work
right
with
over
you.
Here. Biggest stupid dope
that,
in the world.
Come on.
Okay,
it's a stupid
dope. What do you mean by generic?
This
show is retarded,
Let me say something.
What a generic break means.
Stupid means good, right? This is the stupidest hair I ever saw.
Okay.
I mean it. I mean
we don't want to speak on that.
It was from one brother to another. That's it. All right, guys. Run-DMC. We'll be back right
after. We're out of here.
We're all idiots. You know, we've got some good ideas for this show. Coming up in the next couple of weeks, more lesbian dating games.
Yeah.
Why stop with one? Right?
It worked once. Let's do it again.
Everyone kept saying, we got such high ratings with the lesbians. What else can we do with lesbians? I said, why do we have to do anything else with them? Let's just do a lesbian dating game.
That one didn't actually work, so...
Yeah, they didn't actually mate. Hey, good news this week.
What?
Very good news this week. Marvin Kittman, a reporter, not more than a reporter.
A TV columnist.
TV critic, Robin.
Okay, that's a good word.
From New York Newsday.
A reputable paper.
A very reputable paper, one that's not on strike, that actually gets published. And this guy gave us a favorable review, said that Lesbian Dating Game was one of the funniest moments on television.
One of the five funniest moments. That's the top five.
And he said our interview with Reverend Al Sharpton, another of the top five funniest moments.
That's right.
And any critic who rewards us on this program, do we have a picture? Did we show that picture of him already? We actually have constructed a statue of Marvin Kittman. There it is. And isn't that beautiful? And that is just to compliment him and say thank you.
You think that's complimentary?
Nice package. Can you pan down a little bit? I'd like to use my telestrator here.
It is very complimentary if you gave him a nice package.
Let me just clear this up here. That is nothing to be proud of.
Oh.
But it's very beautiful. Hey, Jackie, he's got the same belly button as you. There you go. Very beautiful. And what's that? What is that? Hey, wait a second. What's this thing over here? Is that a Frisbee?
It looks like he's carrying two cymbals.
Discus. Oh, it's a discus. Well, it looked like Robin's diaphragm. If only I could see your diaphragm. Too small. How dare you?
You know what?
Woman is a celebrity.
I used to like you guys.
Yeah. Hey, anyway, let me also tell you that our spokesmodel this week sent us a videotape.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Now, if women want to send us videotapes, we like that. This is Pamela Raines.
What was in her videotape?
Oh, you got the video. Thank you, Dan.
Well, now I'll know, won't I?
How'd you like Dan at the sketch of the, in the beginning of the show?
Oh, he was very believable.
Yes, very good.
What he should be doing is ushering at a movie theater.
Well, he will be soon. Anyway, here's the videotape we got. It caught our attention, so I'll let you see it, Robin.
Okay.
There she is.
Now, I take it this is just a girl. She's not an actress or a model.
I don't know. I think she's just, I think she's a mechanic, actually.
Really?
Yeah, well, you see her with that car. Look at that. There she goes. And she, like, stood around a car a lot and, like, moved her hair a lot.
Uh-huh.
And showed us her body and stuff. Then she got
she
in the car.
She sat in the car with sunglasses.
Yeah. And then she, like... Ooh.
Well, how'd she do that? She just changed outfit.
What a little actress. She couldn't figure out how to start the car. That was the problem. So she just got out of it.
Now, is she advertising that the car wants to be on the show?
Hey, don't you kind of... Oh, standing on one leg, and now... Ooh, yeah. I think her belly is... Ooh, wait a
what's
second.
What's this in the woods thing?
Well, she had to go to the bathroom during the shoot. Actually, I was talking to her before the show. She got lost during the taping of the car thing.
She's looking for the car now.
Yeah, right. Well, this is kind of like a Tarzan and Jane thing, you know what I mean?
Is that a real wooded area?
Oh, ooh. Uh-oh. Well, she had to go to the bathroom in this one. Something about standing next to a wall. Oh, what is this?
This is on a deck in a chair, I think.
Picture yourself on a deck in a chair with, and that's sort of like, you know, the sexy chair.
And there was
pose.
No sound, just...
No sound. So anyway, I'd like to introduce you now to Pamela Raines. There she is. Woo! Yeah, you know, you look a lot better in person than you do in, here, take a seat.
Well, why, actually, I didn't recognize you without the car.
Wow. Look how beautiful you look. Did you lose weight for this show?
Oh, no, I've gained weight.
You really have gained
really?
Weight? Really? Because you look good, because I thought you had flab in the picture, and look at you, how tight you are.
No flab.
And you're not a model, a professional, or
I'm
anything?
I'm not a professional model, but I do a little bit on the side.
You do?
Hobby.
Where did we see you? Did we see you in Vogue, or Penthouse, or any of the magazines?
No.
Where does hobby modeling get you?
Hobby modeling. Well, what do you mean hobby modeling?
Hobby modeling.
It's a hobby, you don't ask for money, you just go out and model and stuff?
Right.
Really?
More or less, yeah.
Would you
she
ever
just models wherever she is. Huh?
Would you ever consider breast implants?
No, I wouldn't.
You would not do that?
Not in a million
what,
years.
What, do you think there's something wrong with her?
No. I like them very much, but I know a lot of the young models are going to that.
Well, that's probably why I'll never make it big, because I won't do it.
You got a lot of cheese in that belly button?
No cheese. It's clean.
Yes. Go for it.
You ask. You're supposed to ask.
Hey, she smells pretty good, too.
She prepared for this show.
All right. Now, we're going to do a commercial with Pamela, since she is a spokesmodel. Are we going to do the aerobics commercial now? We're not doing that now. A little bit later on, you're going to come out. We're going to do a commercial. You're going to be an aerobics girl.
Right.
And I will be the aerobics instructor. Mm-hmm. And then we'll start doing some stuff, and then we'll do some commercials. All right?
Sure.
All right. Very good. All right. We're going to be right back. Jackie and Frank Stallone are here. We're going to hang out with them. Robin's got some news stuff. And also, Stuttering John's going to be here with... Imelda Marcos. We've got a couple of big breaking stories for you. Hey, one of the weird things that happened this past week, too, is Brandon Tartikoff went in the hospital, and we sent him tons of flowers and stuff.
I hope you got him, Brandon.
Brandon's the head programming guy at NBC. Hey, Brandon, we sent you flowers and stuff. Don't you want to put us on that network?
We didn't even get a thank you note, but that's okay.
Yeah, we understand.
We'll take a show.
Yeah, we'll just take a spot on your network. We are very hot, you know. Hey, anyway,
nobody thinks of it.
We got a couple of things going on. By the way, a little later in the show, Stuttering John actually met Imelda Marcos.
I thought that was an interesting combination when you said Stuttering John and Imelda Marcos. You know, she is free.
Yeah, well, he met a whole bunch of people. Leona Helmsley, Imelda Marcos... And Imelda, I think, got hot for John. You're
really?
Right. Yeah, yeah, I think, he sort of reminds her of Ferdinand, the late dictator. Well, anyway, I'm looking forward to
that. I don't know how she managed to see that. But.
Yeah, right. But anyway, what else is going on?
Well, you know how it's the beginning of the year, and it's the time when most heads of states or cities have their State of the Union or State of the City speech, and our very own mayor, Mayor Dinkins, gave his State of the City address this week, and I decided to check on the state of the mayor. You know, the last time he gave a speech, we went along and counted
right.
how many times he wiped his brow or mopped himself during the speech, and he's still sweating, even though he's been on the job for a year.
I'm telling you something. It's like the sweat of the city address. This guy's sweating. What is he so nervous about? You mean he doesn't stop sweating? You'd think now he'd calm down in office, but he sweats.
He was nervous because it was a new job.
Right.
At the beginning.
Right.
But it continues. But let's see if it's getting any better.
All right.
We have a little review. We have what was going on last year in 1990, what he looked like.
Okay. This is 1990.
Yes, this is the old sweating.
He's mopping his brow.
And in 1990, we gauged him, and in 9 minutes, he mopped himself 10 times.
Is that a medical condition?
That means one time every 54 seconds.
Right.
Now, this is this year. He starts mopping before he even gets to the podium.
And he mopped with his hand. Right, that's the first one.
And I guess they must hide those things in the podium for him.
I saw a cool move. He actually, when the crowd starts applauding and they go to the audience, then he starts mopping, too.
You missed a two-handed thing there.
Let me see that one. Wait, I want to rewind that one. I missed it. Everybody, let's take a look at that.
That was a very cool move.
Now, this is from last year, right?
Yeah.
All right, here comes the two-handed one. Let's see. That's behind the ear,
yeah.
The man.
Yeah, oh, sweat. He does everything. He's got quite some
look at
moves.
His eye. Wait a second. Did you see his eye? He gets all full of sweat.
All right, see, now he's mopping already.
Yeah. That's his nose. That's his forehead.
Now watch this in a minute. Here we go.
Forehead and...
Now one hand.
Oh, wait
the
a
other
second.
Hand.
He had two mops in his hand. Holy cow. This is a double mopper. This is a harp.
So in 1991, in 23 times in 32 minutes for a 65% reduction. So he is improving.
You're saying that
and
he's...
this is slow motion, just so you can see technique if you have this problem.
You mean, you're telling me he sweats less now?
Yes.
Look at the guy behind him. It's got to be like PU, you know? It's like, gee whiz.
This is a problem. So anyway, that's the state of the mayor. He is getting better.
He runs our city.
You can stop that, too.
All right.
Also, Howard, you know, I hate to... turn to a serious note. This is sort of a funny show.
Robin, it's a Saturday night. We want laughs, okay? What do you mean serious?
But, you know, something that we have never taken seriously is the AIDS situation.
Yeah, we tell people not to wear rubbers on this show. We're very irresponsible, we admit.
Unfortunately, many, many people are dying.
I know. Isn't that terrible?
But I think we've lost too many people. The fashion industry is being wiped out. The theater industry wiped out.
Yeah.
We've got to stop this loss of life.
Amazingly, our staff lives.
So I thought that maybe we could encourage people to practice safe sex by showing you what they have tried to show on Los Angeles television stations.
Bunch of freaks.
To encourage people to glove up, as they say.
Really?
Yes.
This is an AIDS thing, huh?
This is an AIDS PSA, if you will.
Here we go. Whoa! Get out of here. Oh, yeah.
You know what, you're forgetting something?
Oh, you mean this?
Whoa.
You know what I mean.
Wait a second. Did she just say, are you forgetting something? And then his head went down?
His head disappeared. And I said, yes. No.
Yeah.
He did forget. No.
Hey, if I was her, I'd do that too. My wife will see this and go, why don't you do that? I said, I'm not interested.
Did you forget something, honey?
Yeah, I forgot something, all right.
About 9 years ago.
Yeah, right. I forgot that about 3 days after I met you, I forgot that. I'm not doing that. I know her too well.
But wait a minute. Let's go on. That couldn't be what they meant.
Now, how come she's not sweating?
You haven't got a rubber.
Yeah.
I hate that word.
I could think of an uglier word.
What do you think I've got, AIDS?
Well, you could.
Oh, that's love talk.
Yeah, I'm getting excited.
Thanks a lot.
Or I could. And we wouldn't know.
Look, this doesn't feel right anymore.
Oh, yeah, right. Like, I'd stop.
Yeah. Somewhere.
Only a homosexual would stop at that point.
You don't think this is going to work to deter people from...
First of all, I would convince her not to wear a rubber. What do you mean he got up out of bed? What, just because he got to wear a rubber?
You don't think this is realistic?
Oh, get out of here with that. Liberace would have gotten a rubber and done her. What is that? Liberace would have plowed on. Look at this guy. He's leaving. If you had a face like mine instead of the face you see on your screen right now, you would find a rubber real quick. You'd find six rubbers if that's what she wanted. What kind of thing is that?
There's got to be a drugstore that's stolen.
Yeah, right, Biff. Yeah, there he goes.
Get out of here.
Yeah, got it.
Well, they're trying everything.
Who's the guy in that, Dan Foreman? I'd use a shoe. I would put, let me tell you something. If I was with a woman as good looking as that, I'd put this over my genitalia. I would use this boot like this. I'd say, sweetheart, you'll love it. I'll kill you, but you'll love it. Wouldn't use anything.
Well, I'm just trying to do my part to stop AIDS.
Well, we got to take a break. Yeah. Very excited about tonight's show. Well, Jackie Stallone, she's, of course, the mother of... But now, before Jackie Stallone comes out, with Frank Stallone, her son.
Mm-hmm.
And,
We couldn't get the more famous one?
No, isn't it incredible? I said, Jackie, how about Sylvester?
Bring in one of your kids.
We had Frank a couple of weeks ago. No, you bring Frank. But listen, before she comes out, let's put on our headbands so we look like her.
Yeah, make her feel at home.
Yeah. Because she wears wacky headbands and stuff. You know what I'm doing on mine?
What?
I'm going to put on an antenna. All right. Oh, there you are. Come on, everybody. Sit down.
Hail the conquering hero.
Now, let me introduce everybody.
Like this is needed.
This is Jackie Stallone. Everybody has their headbands on. This, of course, is Frank Stallone.
Yes.
And this is Jackie's boyfriend, Jack.
How do you like that?
And we met him in Los Angeles.
Right.
This is the man that you...
I guarantee you're going to ask him what color he is.
Yeah, what color are you?
Watch your show.
Yeah, what ethnic group are you?
Rainbow.
Really? I mean, seriously, you're so red, you could be an Indian, couldn't you?
You bet.
You guys are a bunch of Arapahoes here.
Look at those. How do we look, huh? Now, Frank has got... Frank is embarrassed by these headbands. He really
is.
Why
is that?
No, come on, the headband. Seriously, you told me the last time I met you, you picked up Mars on these things, if you tune them the right way. Seriously, Jackie.
Yeah.
Come on, Frank, you like these?
He hates them.
No.
He hates them, right?
You think it cuts off your circulation.
I don't know why you should be embarrassed. Since the day he was born, I've been wearing them.
Oh, really? You really have?
So suddenly, should I change because he's famous?
It's almost like we're hippies.
I look like Grandma Moses.
Exactly. Now, this guy, Jack, is your lovemate. Am I correct?
No, he's my...
Gopher.
Gopher?
Gopher.
So, Frank, this is your stepdad in a way, right?
I don't think so.
Yeah. No?
They got they just borrowed their clothes from Rick James.
Because it's a fascinating family tree, you know what I'm saying? Because this guy, you know, he's not your father, he's not your dad.
Yeah.
But is he like a dad to you?
Kind of.
He gives you advice and sits you down?
He does?
I never take advice.
How would Jackie and I have a platonic friendship? She said if we're compatible, within 20 years we'll be married.
I wouldn't ever consider marriage.
You will never marry anyone.
No.
And you would sleep with other men besides Jackie.
Rejected again.
You do not sleep with
Jackie. You are celibate,
no.
As they say?
Well, no, let's say he is.
He is celibate. You won't do anything for Jack to relieve the pressure inside.
We just
neck and
tail.
Problem.
Right, so
no
in other
sex.
Words, you are not lovers, you are just friends.
We hold hands.
All right, now.
But she does sleep with other people.
Right.
No,
oh, Robin, your headband is so beautiful.
Oh, thank you.
Let me just say something. Yes, now.
My kids, I made an oath with my kids, I'd only go with impotent men.
How much, now what's with
thank
Frank?
Thank you.
Frank will not get married. You won't,
no
you're
more,
not
no
into
more
your boys getting married. Your boys, for some reason, think they're too good for any women. Isn't that true?
I think they are.
Yeah.
I know Frank
they
does.
Are,
I'll
too,
tell you
Frank.
That much.
The kind of women they bring around.
Well, you know.
Let me tell you something. The women they bring around, they are too good for them.
They really are. Because Brigitte Nielsen, you hate it. hated. They were trash.
Well, if I thought the kind of girls my kids bring around, if I thought they were going to have trash like this, I'd never educated them.
Really? They just go after trashy women
who
sleep
with them. I'd have sent them to a brothel.
It shows you how bad we are. She educated us, and we still picked those girls.
Are they like common whores?
I don't even think they can make it as a whore.
Really? Unbelievable.
I think they have to give it away.
Really?
Well, there goes my love life.
Yeah. What about Helmsley's latest girlfriend? Don't you like her?
I don't want to comment.
No, she's
very
nice.
What are you coaching her for?
No, she is nice.
She doesn't think she's wonderful. Frank, you think she's
wonderful. Well, let me just say, for a truck driver, she'd be fine. But damn, if a guy makes $100 million a year and 3 college degrees, I think he could do better. Oh. That's my opinion.
Oh, man. Well, I'm glad you got that off your chest.
Nobody pleases you.
Thanks.
Nobody pleases you. Really, it's impossible.
Well, bring me around someone that pleases me.
Who would please you for your
someone
son?
Someone like you.
Yeah, I would please you.
I'd marry you.
Come here, Frank. Why don't you marry me?
No.
What do you mean, someone like me? You are not wearing a bra.
I certainly am.
Oh,
it's
you are.
Me.
I'm sorry for looking at your mom that way, but your mom is attractive. What can I say? She is an attractive woman. She's a very good-looking woman.
I would pick someone like you for my daughter.
You would pick someone like me for
my sons? Yeah. I think my kids should avoid trashy girls.
Oh, okay.
You do.
I think the girls I have are nice.
Jackie Stallone only thinks the good enough women for Frank and Sly are Diane Sawyer, yeah.
Barbara
Walters, and who was the other one?
Princess Di, because really, I think she'd play on the side.
Don't you understand that Frank
really.
And Sly want women who will just have sex with them? Don't you see that guys just want to relieve themselves? Look at this guy over here, this guy Jack.
I'm chomping at the bit.
Now, you've written this book.
Yes, and you're in it.
This is star power. This is about, you can tell your fortune from this.
Uh-huh. Well, you can
tell your prediction for the future?
I have more written down for you.
So how do you get these powers?
I went to school for 17 years.
You're saying that anybody can go to school and get the powers to predict the future?
Not the power, the knowledge.
Really?
Well,
I went to school for 17 years and I got a high school diploma. She got the knowledge?
Yeah. And,
well,
and
no.
She's got a book and you don't.
No, I went to astrology school for 17 years.
Frank, you can't get your mother under control? I mean, really, what is the deal?
I don't know. Every girl I meet, I'm so used to it because I grew up with astrology all the time.
He's a good astrologer.
It was like a bad habit. Every girl I'd see is like, what is your sign?
I don't believe in it.
I had a nice prediction for you. I'll take it back.
No. Go ahead. What is the prediction?
I did. Basically, your show was up for renewal on an eclipse.
Yeah.
And being that you're a Capricorn, your show will be renewed and be much bigger and better.
That's not good.
Ooh.
Well, I can't worry about it. No, and bigger. And Howard, say it. You heard it here. I mean, I could have told you the opposite because I do TV shows for renewal contracts.
Well, tell us
on
something bad that's going to happen to somebody. Tell us something bad that's going to happen.
Well, such as what?
I mean, circulation's going to cut off in your head in about 10 minutes.
I tell you, my head's going to fall up in this headband.
I don't like to say bad things.
Now, I read the book. And I predict that Frank will get crabs this year.
Frank, oh, you want to hear a story about crabs? Can I tell it?
No.
Oh,
no.
Why?
I never ate crabs.
Well, just a minute. You did so once.
Mom, I used to go crabbing in the Chesapeake Bay. I never had
crabs.
One day, Frankie was about 15 years old, and suddenly we lived in Philadelphia. Oh, he'll scream.
And he had to shave all his
pubic
hair?
No, this girl sat on his lap.
A girl sat on his lap.
And he could swear she gave him crabs. And what do you think he did? He doesn't know whether he did or not. He went to her father's house and knocked on the door and said, your daughter gave me crabs and wanted the father to pay for a medical physical to Dr. Bedford.
Are you serious?
I know it.
You got to be proud of your boys. You got to be. You got to be proud.
I mean, that's probably the only case of like someone sitting on your lap fully clothed and giving you crabs.
How could that happen?
Now, tell me some more predictions from the, you're doing this astrology. You have
all
predictions
about. I have it all written down.
All right.
I was in Russia 2 months ago, and I had to do the predictions for the state of Russia, the economy, and Gorbachev's future. So I said,
do you get over to Russia? I mean, who pays for you to come over to Russia and do these predictions?
I went over as a tourist, and by accident or coincidence or destiny, my dream was to meet the Gorbachevs. I didn't think I stood a prayer, and that was going to stop me from going to Russia. But I found an interpreter who happened to be a friend of an interpreter of Gorbachev's who gave Risa my book. And by giving her my book...
You met with Risa?
Both of them.
You sat really? With Gorbachev?
I spent 10 days with him in their villa.
You mean to tell me those two maniacs who run Russia
they're
were...
not maniacs. They're both lawyers. They're very smart and
they were reading
fine.
The book, and then they contacted you and said, I must meet with you?
They sent their KGB people to my hotel, and after the KGB took a limo about 50 miles into the country and really checked me out.
Jack, is this true?
This is true.
I was with
you. Let me tell you something.
Frank, do you believe this? You stroll and your mother goes to Russia?
Did she call you on Russian TV. I was on three times at a 30 million population. It was so good they satellited into BBC in London.
Yeah.
And basically, after that, I couldn't walk the streets in Russia. I was mobbed. And at the same time, you had Michelle Pfeiffer. Who's this ball-headed fellow?
Sean Connery.
Yeah. Ball-headed fellow.
They're all running around. No one cared about them.
When you met Gorbachev, did you offer him a headband to cover the stain on his head?
No.
No. Why not?
But I'll tell you something. It's in the news, and someone's going to show me pictures. All the Russian women are running around headbands. They can't afford hats and all, but they have a headband on.
Do you know they assigned 8 KGB bodyguards for Jackie? All the people were coming up wanted.
I think the headbands are wrapped too tight on both of you. I'm not kidding around about this, and you guys know that.
I was wondering if you'd donate that to Risa.
I'm telling you, I like
wear it.
Now, let's get this straight.
Howard, you look fantastic with that headband.
You two guys,
don't take it off.
You two guys do not make love to one another.
Well, what do you call making love? What's your definition?
We neck and pet, but we don't make love.
You guys have never had sexual intercourse.
What do you call
not yet. I'm waiting. 20 years from now.
Of course, a man and a woman joining together in unison. Would you say you two don't? I don't understand, Jack, what your role in all this is.
I'm anticipating 20 years from now we will do it.
Let's call Sylvester. Come on, dial him up.
Oh, I don't know his number.
Oh, what do you mean?
I don't.
Why are you guys scared of Sylvester?
I'm not afraid.
I was so afraid of this guy.
No. I really.
Jackie, why are you afraid of Sylvester?
I'm afraid.
Yeah, call his house.
I don't
have. Dial 9.
What
one.
Is his number?
I don't know.
You dial the number.
They don't know his number.
I swear I don't know.
You don't know Sylvester's number.
That'll stop my head.
And Jackie can't summon it up through her headband?
Well, yeah.
Jackie, here, borrow my antenna.
Yeah.
And you'll get it into the headband. Here.
Why don't we call the police department? Have them call him.
I give up on you guys.
It's like Roach Hotel. It's like, what is this?
You look like a little bit like.
Very nice.
Like Connie Francis from Uranus with all of that. Look at that.
I can't stand to look like her.
You hate her.
I hate her looks.
You hate Connie Francis.
I really don't like her.
You don't like anybody in show business, do you?
No, I'll tell you why I don't like her. When she was a big star, my kids, we lived in Philadelphia, and she made a personal appearance, and my kids said, Mommy, could we see Connie Francis now? So I said, oh, sure, Mommy will see that you see Connie Francis. Now, suddenly, Connie, I was just Jacqueline Stallone, Miss Housewife, nobody.
Right.
So I take these two little kids to the hotel door at the Sheraton, and I bang on the door, and they're standing here like this, and suddenly Miss Francis comes to the door, and she opens the door, and I said, Miss Francis, my kids, I promise that they can say hello to you. She looked at me and said, how dare you?
Really?
And slammed the door in the face. And that was a terrible trauma.
Can you blame her, though?
Yeah. She lost her voice.
There was a woman
screaming at Jackie.
And I mean, come on.
And I think basically this is why these kids, every time someone wants an autograph or a picture, they're there. I think it left them such a shock.
Really?
And made me look, I was humiliated. Today,
that's a beautiful story.
Open the door.
Frank, let me give your credentials, too. Now, Frank, of course, is touring the country. He will be appearing in Hudson Hawk with Bruce Willis and Danny Aiello. I only hope there's a big hit, and then Sylvester will be coming to him for money. I would love that. And this will be coming out in May, right, Frank?
Yeah, it's a wonderful movie.
Sylvester ever give you, like, millions of dollars? Does he ever lay any money on his mother?
No.
Seriously.
He gave me a basket of cookies for Christmas.
And he does not give you any money?
I don't
all of his millions. All of his millions, and he will not give
you
money.
He's sitting on it.
Really?
Yeah.
He don't you? Does that bother you a little
poor.
Bit?
No. He lives in total fear that he's going to be poor and starve to death, so I think he sits on it.
Well, that's very nice. A mother would be
okay. Feel this way.
Unfortunately, you now
Frank
have to be with...
Frank doesn't give you any money either, but Frank he doesn't have any.
Frank doesn't have money to give you, so, right? Frank, you got your more money, right?
Yeah, sure.
You shouldn't?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
We got to go. Jackie Stallone, star power. Robin, we're back, and it's a Saturday night. We love being here. And by the way, we're not going to be here in next week. I think there's a telethon.
A telethon?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, I did hear about this.
Yeah.
CP or something?
Yeah, can't they, like, cancel the telethon for an hour and let us come back on? Hey, what do we care? It'll be a nice rest for us. CP
sure.
Telethon.
Why not?
But, hey, look who's here. Stuttering John.
We're letting him back on the show. All right.
We're having him back on the show because he stutters so good. We sent him over to the big Cindy and Joey Adams birthday bash.
Well, it was Joey's 80th birthday party.
Yeah, right. Yeah, and by the way, that's a real important event in New York. the big Joey Adams annual birthday bash. So many people are into him.
Well, they changed street names and everything for that.
That's right. Joey was 80 for the third time.
I don't think he knew what was happening, actually.
Did he look like he knew what was happening? But you weren't even allowed inside, right?
I didn't get to see Joey.
Habada. So you didn't get to see Joey, but No. You got to see many celebrities.
Yeah.
Which is what we're going to see tonight.
Yep.
Okay. Got the premise, Robin?
I think I understand what's supposed to happen. He's standing outside.
Yeah, we're standing.
Hi. Thanks,
man. Here we go.
Tony, can I ask you questions for this is for the Howard Stern Show, tape the broadcast?
Oh, great.
Hi, who do you think will die first? Bob Hope, Milton Berle, George Burns, or Joey Adams?
I hear that Bob Hope's not going to die until he finds out who Brooke Shields is going to marry.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Should ugly people be allowed to have children?
Well, it's all the way you look at it.
Does it bother you when people talk to you while you're on the ball? Does it bother you when people talk to you while you're on the ball?
Well, no one talks to me when that happens.
No?
No.
All right. Thanks a lot, Tiny.
Pleasure.
Appreciate it.
Pleasure.
Yeah, let him call me whatever you want. No problem.
Okay, your question, Leona, this is for the Howard Stern Show. Take the broadcast.
Hi. Oh, worst nightmare.
Does it bother you when people talk to you when you're on the ball, Leona?
No. I saw her. No.
That's the wildest thing you ever did sexually.
She'd rather go to jail than talk to John.
She'd rather be in jail.
Isn't it nice, two entertainment giants under one roof, Leona and John?
I can't remember. There have been so many things. How can I choose?
Well, let me get back on that.
Yeah, we didn't miss that question.
Yeah, we don't want to miss that one.
That's the wildest thing you ever did sexually.
I can't remember. There have been so many things. How can I choose?
Have you ever gone to the bathroom in a public pool as an adult?
Oh, no.
Who do you...
Hey, man. Hey, well, let me...
Look at the guy in the...
Whoa. Hey, he's got to be happy. When you got a fox like her.
He's passing wind.
He is not passing wind, John. John, leave the jokes to me, all right?
Be quiet.
John, you are passing wind. Let's get back.
Bring Joey.
My love and friendship and undying devotion.
But no sexual tricks.
This is the Howard Stern Show.
Yeah. You like him?
He did nothing for me, so why should I knock myself?
He's a big fan of yours.
He is a big fan.
Yeah, yeah.
Then I'll help him out. What's on your mind?
Were you surprised, son, that Johnny Carson beat his wife?
I wouldn't even discuss that. That's not my business.
Does it bother you?
I'm not his attorney, and I'm not his judge, and I'm not your lawyer. And
why does Jackie Mason travel with a lawyer at all times?
He never knows when he's going to get into trouble.
What is going on there? I mean, wait, is he going to say something?
And a divorce lawyer at that. That's Raoul Felder.
It's unbelievable. Oh, by the way, I'm not supposed to do the show with my jacket off.
Oh, really? Because you
don't
look...
They say my shoulders and breast area aren't built up enough, so...
You don't look like a man?
Yeah, I don't look like a man. I've been actually told by our executive producer not to expose these. All right, let me take a quick break here. We'll come back with more of the Joey Adams birthday bash right after these words. Been informed our spokesmodel is more muscular than me. And hey, what can I tell you? I'm not a muscular macho
Maybe
man.
She should have worked you out.
You find me attractive?
I do, yeah.
You really do?
Yes.
You think that I'm attractive?
I think you are, yes. But I've been looking at you a long time.
Yeah, but I think you're attractive. I do.
And you've been looking at me a long time.
Well, there you go.
I guess we've grown on each other.
Oh, yeah, like that'll happen. Robin and I don't kiss. We're very asexual with one another. One time.
Well, every once in a while we kiss on the cheek.
One time Robin was very sexual with me. What we were alone in my office where I work.
You're going to tell this story.
Yeah, and Robin had spilled something on her dress, so she was just standing there in panties and bra.
Yeah, I took my dress off.
Yeah.
Because I sort of felt like, you know,
and
you're
her
my
legs,
brother.
And you had your legs akimbo on my desk.
I sat up on the desk with desk.
Right,
desk.
On the desk. And you were sitting there.
With my legs akimbo, yes.
She's nervous because I'm telling this story. So she's
I
in
can't
bra.
Believe this is the first time we've ever revealed this.
So then it was unbelievable. She,
what did she, I do next? She, I don't remember.
She was wet. From the stuff
I spilled on myself.
So she starts rubbing against me to dry herself off, and she achieved orgasm.
First time.
Now, first time in her life, ever. All right, let me...
So I'm grateful to you.
That's a little story. We have a lot of prisoners watching us. So, guys, you can put your pants back on now, okay?
I'm done.
Right, no problem. I, of course, never climaxed during the session. Only Robin achieved orgasm.
And it's one of the great disappointments of my life.
You bet. Well, now that we've gotten that out of the way, let's get back to the big, important Joey Adams story. My head still hurts from the Jackie Stallone interview. Now, you were with Jackie Mason when we left.
Yeah.
And I'm not your lawyer, and I don't think it's proper for me to come.
Does it bother you?
Oh, it is. Imelda Marker.
Imelda Marker.
All right. Check.
And the whole crowd raises over. Look at her.
Whoa. How did she get off?
Oh, that was me.
Hi, Imelda.
Imelda.
Oh, look at John.
Hi. Go. Imelda, can I ask you a question? This is the Howard Stern Show. Tape the broadcast.
With the lawyer. With the lawyer together.
Imelda, can I ask you a question? This is the Howard Stern Show. Tape the broadcast. Does it bother you when people speak to you while you're on the bowl?
Imelda, Marcos. I love you. Beautiful.
Imelda. Sounds still there.
Oh, yeah.
You. Hey.
Now, what happened there, John?
Some guy told me to get, you know, get out of the way, you joker, and stuff started saying to me.
Oh, like he had more important questions.
Yeah, oh, he has important questions for Imelda.
And what's all those hand signals? You know? Imagine all of those shoes and not one shoe around to hit John over the head with. Let's get back to the action, Robin.
Imelda, do you think that ugly people should be allowed to have children?
Imelda, right here, please.
Hey, look, he's consulting the papers.
Imelda, if you pass gas at home in front of others, do you blame the family dog?
This was worse than the trial.
Do you think that?
Come on.
Imelda, you think that? Does it bother you when like people?
Hold it a second.
Oh, that's too funny.
I think that's worth seeing again.
Yes, definitely. I need an instant replay.
Hey, Imelda, welcome to America. Your worst nightmare, the Howard Stern Show.
Imelda, if you pass gas at home in front of others, do you blame the family dog?
Look at John.
Do you think that should... Do you think that...
Come on.
Imelda, you think that... Do you think that... Does it bother you when like people talk to you while you're on the bowl?
No, not at all. I always hope Howard will call then.
But
do you
think that ugly people should have children?
I don't think ugly people should have children, no. I told your mother that.
Hi, yeah. Can I ask you a question? This is just for the Howard Stern Show, tape the broadcast. What did you do with the money?
I don't know what you're talking about.
The money that your mom gave you for singing lessons.
I never took singing lessons.
Next question? Bess, everybody else answer me.
Bess, right behind you, please. Before you go in, one
come on, Bess.
Right,
just one question.
Oh, where's my other
question? Who do you think's going to die first, George Burns or Joey Adams?
It's a tie.
Thanks, Bess.
You look one. Hey, you think she's psychic like Jackie Stallone? Oh, man.
Well, she is a Miss America. She remained composed in the interview section of the contest.
Really, you know, that's what's so great about Miss America. They all know how to retain their composure. Well, that is exciting. Is there any more on this?
I don't know. Calm down.
Let's get back to the action.
Football tonight. Would you pose nude for $1 million?
No.
What's the wildest thing that you've ever done sexually?
I couldn't say it on TV.
Oh, come on.
Look at this woman. All dolled up. Sidney Biddle-Barrows. Why is she not in jail? If I was a whore master, if I had a bunch of hookers working for me, and I treat them nice. I pay their insurance. I don't even get to run around at parties. Let me put my jacket on. I look like a woman.
You look like a crazy woman.
I look like a crazy woman. A common woman. Now I look more masculine in my motorcycle jacket, don't I? Who is this Sidney Biddle-Barrows to be running around at parties?
In real fur.
A common whoremaster. Well, really, I mean, wasn't she a whoremaster?
That's what I understand, yeah. She called it an escort service, but they were doing it.
Makes me nuts. Let's get back to the action. Whoa.
Do you have a quota?
A black guy?
Hey, wait, I take it all back. Yeah. All right.
Okay, we haven't done it yet. Sitting right in front.
Who's that guy?
Hang on. Do you have a quota?
A what?
Do you have a quota?
I don't know what you're talking about.
You know, like 50 cents? Hi, Liz, how you doing?
How are you?
Can I ask you a question?
No.
No, she's had it with you. We remember your last interview with Liz Smith. Hey, nice jacket.
I couldn't wait to eat.
Yeah. Animal died.
She was on her way to the buffet, Liz Smith, and did not want to be interrupted under any circumstances until she had eaten everything in sight.
The last time she had eaten was in the car on
right.
the way there.
Yeah, they don't feed her at Live at 5, so she was pretty hungry. Although she did eat the leopard that you see there. That coat was actually eaten by
that
her before.
That had to be two or three leopards.
Yeah, I believe so. They killed like 7 leopards just so she could run around like that. Gee, is she... Wait, she looked at that coat and said, if I put this on, I'll be attractive?
Hey, Regis.
Oh, there he is.
This is for the Howard Stern Show tape for broadcast.
Regis!
Can I ask you a question, Regis? Regis, only just one question. Come on, man. I came all the way here, Regis.
So did he.
Donald, hi, can I ask you a question?
How are you?
This is for the Howard Stern Show tape to broadcast.
He's a great guy. I listen to him all the time. He really is.
Would you ever put a
cool.
marshmallow in your butt cheeks?
Hold it a second. I talked over that. I apologize.
Wait a minute. I got to hear what he's saying.
The guy likes us. What do you do? Oh, Regis. Like, he's some big deal. King Regis.
On,
king of New York.
I came
loser.
Over here, Regis. Hey, Donald, hi, can I ask you a question?
How are you?
This is for the Howard Stern Show tape to broadcast.
He's a great guy. I listen to him all the time. He really is.
Would you ever put a marshmallow in your butt cheeks to benefit world hunger, Donald?
Say hello to Howard.
I will. Look, could you just answer one question for me, Donald? It'll really make my day. Donald, look.
Donald,
get back in
here. Marla passed him away.
Donald, just one question.
Listen.
Donald, does it bother you when people talk to you while you're on the ball, Donald?
Oh. Yeah, look at that. Well,
you think that's it?
I guess you did a good job.
Thanks.
That
Thanks.
Was intense.
Thanks.
Intense.
Thank you.
Standing ovation.
Yes.
Thanks. Thank you very much.
Imelda had to be the greatest thing, though.
You bet. Imelda was good.
You think she understood me? Or?
Hey, I'm trying to sign off, okay? What do I look like, Dick Cavett?
What is this?
What is this?
Oh, right.
Oh, a birthday. Well, isn't that attractive? I guess the same guy who made the... Ooh, look at this. The heck is going on? Wait a second.
Is that what you've always wanted, Howard?
Gee, how thrilling. That was the most erotic. Well, thank you to our spokesmodel, Pamela Rain.
Yes.
Right. Thank you. My birthday. Gee, I'm really behaving like a 37-year-old tonight, aren't I? Don't tell my children I work here. I won't tell them either. Listen, we have to leave. Thanks, everybody. We won't be back next week, but the week after with an original episode.
All right.
See ya.
Thanks to Sam Ash for all the musical instruments, and thanks to Mazer's Bakery in Lindhurst for the sculptured cake.
The night's got a whole new beat. There's music and dancing on The Party Machine with Nia Peoples. Weeknights at midnight, right after the Arsenio Hall Show. And tonight at 6, higher education sinks to an all-time low with John Belushi in Animal House, right here on LA's very independent Channel 13.